Unfortunately, in this day and age, the majority of ovarian cancers present at a late stage. Statistically, 80% of all ovarian cancers present at an advanced stage, either stage 3 or 4. Treatment options for those patients usually requires a combination of both surgery and chemotherapy. New advances in ovarian cancer at this point in time really rely upon what we call adjuvant treatment for ovary cancer. And what I mean by that is surgery for ovarian cancer, as for several decades, its main goal is to what we call surgically debulk the cancer. And what that means is remove all the macroscopic or all of the disease that we can see or touch at the time of surgery. Many times we can't remove every single piece of cancer that we can see or feel, but the goal is to leave as little a nodule of cancer behind following surgery. And what we strive to do is leave any cancer behind that will be smaller than 1 centimeter. That's the goal. And from a surgical standpoint, that may require removal of parts of the intestinal tract or urinary tract, etc. But surgery's goal is to remove the large pieces of cancer and leave the smallest amount of residual tumor behind as we can. And that's what chemotherapy's for. Chemotherapy works better on small implants of cancer than it does on large implants of cancer. For many patients, we are employing something called intraperitoneal chemotherapy, which is when a patient receiving chemotherapy receives a combination of some intravenous chemotherapy, which is the standard traditional approach, and some patients will receive a combination where they also receive intraperitoneal chemotherapy, or a lot of patients consider this a belly wash chemotherapy, where there's a port implanted in the abdomen where we infuse chemotherapy directly into the abdominal cavity. And in patients that can tolerate and be administered intraperitoneal chemotherapy, it's been shown that those patients actually do better and have a longer survival rate. And so in this day and age, that's what most of us strive to do, is to have an excellent surgical result followed by a combination intravenous and intraperitoneal chemotherapy. The challenge to the medical environment is to catch ovarian cancer at an earlier stage. And there are some new blood tests that are doing a better job of that than we did 10 years ago. There are some new screening algorithms or triage algorithms for an ovarian mass that help patients get to a trained professional such as a GYN oncologist for their initial operation, which in this time still is the most important aspect of a woman's care with ovarian cancer, is that her initial diagnosis and initial management is performed by a GYN oncologist. Most notably, there are some blood tests. One's called the OVA1, which is a blood test that screens for 5 different analytes in a woman's blood to help us dictate whether or not an ovarian mass is cancer or not. And that test does do a better job than some of the other more traditional approaches that we use. And so, again, another challenge to women that have been found to have an ovarian mass is to definitely seek out the right physician. The good news is the vast majority of an ovarian mass that's seen on CT scan or ultrasound is benign. It is not a cancer, the vast majority of the time. The challenge for the medical team is to weed out who are those cancers and who is not. And certainly seek second opinions. Seek out GYN oncologist if you have an ovarian mass for a second opinion or a surgical consultation, because it's important that you get the best preoperative evaluation in the event that it is a cancer that you're taken care of by the right medical professional.